Hello everyone, I am not the lazy game reviewer, although I am kind of lazy, I do review games. The point is that both Clint and I are covering edutainment titles this month, and both of us decided to start things off with Animal Quest. Now, since it's April 1st, we figured it'd be kind of fun to see if we could handle each other's web shows. And hey, after we're done here, feel free to head on over to www.pixelships.com/edg to check out my show, Ancient DOS Games. Now, fortunately, Clint gave me a list here of things I should be talking about on his show, so let's get started. First up, we have company history. Animal Quest was made by Live Software, and they made a number of games, including a Billy the Kid game, which kind of sucked, actually. Yeah, I don't really know too much about them. Moving on. Let's see. Sarcastic comment. Animal Quest is a game where you just sort of go around questing with animals, kinda.
Hello?
Yeah?
What the balls, man? You said you had this, bra and panties.
Look, I'm sorry, okay? It's just I haven't worked without a script in over a year. Speaking of, did you fix my web show yet?
Oh yeah, sure, yeah. Dude, you wrote the whole thing in freaking Pascal. I've never even seen a line of that in my life. It may as well be a flavor of sherbet or something.
Please tell me you didn't try recompiling the fourth wall protection algorithms.
Why would you ask that? Really, what's the worst that could happen?
Alright, so seriously now, what is Animal Quest? Well, it's one of the many edutainment games I played as a geeky youngster, and when you didn't have many games to choose from, it was pretty sweet. It was developed and published by Alive Software, also known simply as Alive Soft, in 1991. Alive was a one-man band, so to speak, comprising of the work of Bill Deeds of Santa Clara, California. He worked as a software engineer at a semiconductor company in the mid-80s, but I guess it wasn't long before he decided semiconductors were only semi-awesome and computer games were completely awesome, and started AliveSoft in 1989. Initially, he was developing simple shareware puzzle games and interactive thingamabobs like Crazy Shuffle, Magic Crayon, and PC Jigsaw. But it wasn't long before he moved on to action and adventure games like Alive Sharks and Billy the Kid Returns. By the time he was done, he had a catalog of 12 games released under the shareware business model, and one of those was Animal Quest, a game conceptualized by Nancy Ayash. Back in the day, I had the early shareware version copied to this disc here, but we'll be looking at the full registered 4.01 version from here on out. Animal Quest starts with a title screen, with different musical compositions playing depending on the sound device you have activated. Like in the case of the Sound Blaster card selected here, it's Mozart's Turkish March. You are asked if you are smart like a fox, strong like a bear, can leap like a frog, jump like a deer, howl like a wolf, squeak like a rat, soar like an owl, or sprint like a cat. If the answer is yes to all of the above, then chances are you are a mutated freak and should probably turn off the computer and turn yourself in to the nearest school for gifted youngsters. You then come to an off-putting, off-center menu, that really bothers me, with four options to choose from: forest animals, ocean animals, jungle animals, and young lion animals. And that's somewhat of an odd choice in young lion mode there. Although maybe not, since it wasn't added as an option until versions that came out shortly after Disney's The Lion King in 1994, so if this little cash-in wasn't intentional, then color me surprised and just blame my cynicism. Also, this isn't the only difference in the later versions of the game, as previous versions also included a lot more graphics and sound modes to choose from, including a high-res SVGA display mode, which changed the interface of the game a fair amount. This has to be one of the few games I know of that significantly reduces the options available to you on subsequent editions. I'm showing the latest 4.01 version with EGA graphics here, since the SVGA mode is really just EGA anyways, with a bunch of ugly high-res menu options on top of it. And I'll start off with Forest Animals, since it feels the most appropriate at this point in my current reality's plane of existence. You're then given the option to choose a creature to remote control, separated by difficulty depending on how many predators it has and what it can eat. Choose your destiny, and you're then dropped into the game with absolutely nothing happening until you tell it to. You see, Animal Quest is a turn-based game, so with every individual tile you move, the other creatures on screen will move with you. The entire goal of the game is to demonstrate the food chain in action by hunting down prey and avoiding becoming the hunted yourself. Plants and animals are scattered throughout each screen, placed on individual tiles, and you use either the mouse or the keyboard to move one at a time. I use the keyboard because I like it, and the mouse just doesn't feel right to me on tile-based games like this. And really, using a mouse to control a lion is like something straight out of a freaking Aesop's fable, and I am simply not prepared to endure such morality lessons right now. Basically, all you do is move up, down, left, or right, and eat everything you can on each screen to try and get the most points. Move off the side of the screen to the next screen, rinse and repeat. Once you reach 49 points, you gain the ability to launch the charge song. And move diagonally, which is absolutely invaluable for outmaneuvering the more dangerous animals. Especially the most dangerous animal of them all, man. Oh man, you so evil. Hunting down anything and everything just for sport, screw you, man. If you happen to get killed by something, you'll lose a certain amount of points, and perhaps lose your diagonal ability in the process. Before long, you'll get through all 12 screens and reach your home, where your mate and babies are just chilling in their tiles, waiting for you to arrive and not give them anything because you ate it all on the way there, you dick. And that's really it as far as gameplay goes, even with the other modes. Ocean, Jungle, Young Lion, it's all food chain stuff pretty much, so just go out and chain that food up and enjoy. While Young Lion mode deserves a quick mention since its inclusion is impressively pointless. You already had a freaking lion in the freaking Jungle Animals mode, except now you're controlling Anti-Simba here, and your only predators are pink hyenas. Really, did they get blasted with paint by anti-fur PETA protesters or something? You're supposed to wait until after they're skinned, you silly vegans. All kidding aside, this mode is really dumb and totally pointless. But disregarding the tacked-on Young Lion cash-in thing, I guess Animal Quest is effective enough at teaching kids about the food chain. But really, even as a kid when I was playing this, I already assumed that a bear that sounds an awful lot like a cow has to be totally awesome. While a mouse is pretty much nature's whipping boy and is screwed no matter what. I mean, basically it comes down to if it's smaller than you, you eat it. You're not really learning any specifics here, since it doesn't bother to tell you what each thing is as you're eating it. Well, I guess there are those buttons along the bottom of the screen that give you more information on things like the complete food chain and factual details of each animal. But as a kid, I never looked at this stuff. I just wanted to go around and devour everything in sight. I didn't care what I was eating or why, just that I was eating things and having fun. So really, it could be argued that Animal Quest both succeeds and fails for the same reasons. It's kind of effective in teaching kids the food chain because it lets them play around with it in a fun way. But because it's fun to play, the food chain details tend to get a bit lost amongst all the primal snacking. In a way, it's kind of a timeless game since it's so straightforward, although getting a copy of the registered version is probably not going to happen. The website for AliveSoft still has the game listed, but you can't actually buy it anymore, it seems, and I've received no answer from the email address provided. Now, that's fine though, you're not missing much at all by just trying out the shareware game. It's got nice 16-color high-res graphics, some decent music and sound effects, lets you gorge yourself on tons of animals without somehow exploding, and the high score system kept me playing it over and over as a young lad. But nowadays, it's just a nostalgic memory of childhood and nothing more. And I'm totally okay with that,